What's up, everybody? This is Investing Sensei here, bringing you episode 41 of the Webull Option Adventures, where our goal is to sell options and collect that premium so that it could eventually replace our 9-to-5 job if we wanted to. So I'm just sharing my journey as I get to that. My long-term goal is to try to get this portfolio to where it's generating me about $800 to about $1,000 a week. We are way far away from achieving that yet, but I think over time we will get there. I'm actually getting a lot better at selling options, actually picking the right strike prices so that we don't get assigned. And so, you know, right now I think we are down quite a bit in the portfolio, but I think once we recover, I have a lot more knowledge and skill sets to actually pick some better trades. And once we recover, I think we'll make quite a bit of money. Right now we are collecting crumbs. They do add up over time, so I'm not worried. But anyways, the portfolio right now is at $40,799.23. As you'll see that we are down about 30.30%, and that's actually a total of about negative $17,379.50. One of the things is that I am going to show you guys three trades that I'm going to potentially enter this coming week, so that I think they will become very profitable trades. We will probably be able to close them out about 50-60%, hopefully within a couple weeks, which I'll show you guys in a couple trades that I did earlier, and I was able to trade them. Well, I guess I was able to close them for about 50-55% profit. So that was a pretty good trade, and we still had quite a bit of time for it to expire. So I'll show you guys those trades in a little bit. But as you'll see, our cash balance is at $813.23. And then our options buying power is at $6,732.78. So the first trade we do have here, guys, is NEO. So we do have three cash secured puts at NEO with a strike price of $34. And it's actually going to expire on the 8th of October. So this is the last week for this option. We did put this trade about maybe a month trade, so we've been holding for this one. And so now Theta is going to be kicking in strong, especially over the weekend. You'll see that we did collect about 43 cents or $43 per contract, so that was around maybe $120 or so. So we should start seeing this option decay very quickly this coming week. And again, if NEO is trading above $34 by Friday of this coming week, we're just gonna keep the whole premium, and I'm probably gonna end up being able to close it way earlier. But we'll see how the market reacts this coming week. So, you know, it's very volatile. But the next one we do have here, guys, is 400 shares of NEO. We did end up selling four covered calls at a strike price of $39. It actually is going to expire, well, I guess it expired yesterday on the 1st of October, and we collected $3 per contract, so we collected about what, $12, and it actually expired worthless because NEO closed at $35.33, so definitely nowhere near strike price of $39. And this was a trade that I placed maybe around, I believe, Thursday, so that was pretty good for just 2 days. And so as you'll see, we're going to continue to recover because we are selling covered calls below our cost basis. So we got to be kind of cautious, because otherwise you're going to have to roll these covered calls so that they don't get taken away, your shares. The next one here, guys, that we do have is 300 shares of Tattoo Chef. I actually went ahead and sold three covered calls at a strike price of $20, and they actually expired yesterday on the 1st of October, and we collected $5, and that was a total of $15, and again, it expired worthless. Tattoo Chef closed at $18.60, and our strike price was $20, so we got to keep the whole premium plus our shares. The next one here that I'm going to be going through real quick, because I will be showing you guys a couple trades that I'm potentially entering this coming week, depending on how the market is. So the next one is SoFi. So we have 200 shares of SoFi. This is actually a covered call that I had to roll over for a couple extended periods. So you'll see we do have two covered calls at a strike price of $18.50. So that's definitely above our cost basis. So if our shares are taken away, I'm fine, completely fine with that, because I'm not going to be losing money. And then it is actually going to expire on the 5th of November. And so we collected $110, or $1.10, which is $110 per contract. So we're going to see how this one trades. We're going to keep leaving it here, and hopefully we can maybe potentially buy it early. So, you know, exit it and then sell another covered call. But we'll see what happens with this one. We're going to keep monitoring. The next one here that you'll see is 200 shares of Mara. So on Mara, we do have two covered calls that we did sell. And so we sold it at a strike price of $38, and it expired yesterday on the 1st of October. We collected $7 per contract, so $14 total. And we got to keep the whole premium plus our shares, because Mara closed at $33.76, and definitely nowhere near our strike price or above it. So that was a pretty good trade. And the last one here, guys, that we do have is Beyond Meat. So we have 100 shares of Beyond Meat. So I was able to sell a covered call on Beyond Meat at a strike price of $117. It expired yesterday on the 1st, and we collected $11 for that contract, and it expired worthless, because Beyond Meat closed at $105.09. So definitely nowhere near a covered call strike price of $117. So we are going to continue selling these type of crumbs until we start recovering. These do add up over time. Obviously, it's not the best situation, but we got to do what we got to do here. As well as, you'll see that our cash balance, well, I guess not our cash balance, but our options buying power is about 6,700. So I have some room to put in a couple trades, which is actually going to lead over to the three trades that I'm potentially considering entering this coming week, especially because if we look at the NEO cash secured puts that I do have, that's about three of them. So three times three, well, I guess three times 3,000 is about 9,000. So I should have close to about 15,000 options buying power. So hopefully we should see some of these trades coming in next week. So we'll see what happens. But one of the ones that I do want to show you that I pointed out with, I'm really liking the 30-day cash secured puts, because they do give me quite a bit of time to collect that premium, especially if the market goes down. I still have plenty of time, and I don't have to worry about rolling it as well. It just starts decaying closer to the once it gets to the 2 week, 1 week. And so it's just a lot easier and safer, and I can select a better strike price that's way out of the money. So that's one of the things I do like about doing 30-day cash secured puts. But let me show you guys the Google Sheets here for one of the ones that I did close this week. So we did actually close ChargePoint, which as you'll see, we actually placed this trade on the 24th of September, and we held it for 6 days. So I closed it on the 29th, and so it actually expired all the way till the 10th of, well, I guess October 22nd. And it was a ChargePoint cash secured put, strike price $16, and we collected 26 cents or $26 per contract, so a total of around $52. And so I was actually able to buy this back in 6 days. So, you know, we collected about $55 or so. I mean, not $55, but 55%. So about $26, $25. If we look at the debits here, it'll show you. So you'll see we paid about $24 actually. So a little bit over, definitely over 50% in profits in 6 days. And we still had plenty of time before the contract even expired. So these three trades that I'm going to show you guys, I hope that they play out like this as well, where we can close them out pretty early. So the first one here, guys, that I do have is Tattoo Chef. So Tattoo Chef is currently trading about $18.49. Currently, if we look at the 3 months, we have the Bollinger Bands and the 30-day moving average. So if we look currently, you'll see that the middle of the Bollinger Bands right around $19.81. The upper band for Tattoo Chef is around $21.87. And then the lower bound of the Bollinger Band is at $17.74, and then the 30-day moving average is at $19.98. So current price right now is way below that, so we should hopefully see this bounce back up as well. Since you see the lower bound, this is actually, we should try to play around a $16 strike price. We should be pretty safe, or $15. And the other thing is the RSI. You'll see that it's around $42. Well, it's not $42, but 42 is the RSI. So we're getting close to the oversold territory, which we should see movement upwards. So that is one of the trades that I am considering. If I move back over to the Webull, I can show you guys Tattoo Chef. So if we look at Tattoo Chef here, you'll look, if we look at the options, we think maybe potentially, so Tattoo Chef is going to have earnings. I try to avoid earnings because that could make the movement of the stock price much higher. So Tattoo Chef is going to do earnings around, I believe, the 8th of November. So I try to avoid that. I usually look at the earnings dates before I try to place these trades. So one of the ones that I'm considering is on the 29th of October, which is about 27 days from now. And so if we look at the puts, you'll see that we could potentially do the 16 strike price, and we collect about $20 is what the bid middle is, about 30. So we could collect between $20 to $30 in premium for $16 strike price, which is a little bit over 1% to 2%, depending on what the premium that we collect. If we collect about $20, then that is about a 1% for the month, which I think is pretty reasonable. I think we can collect 50% of it pretty quick, depending on what the stock market is doing. The other one, if we were to collect about 30, we would be close to about 2% in premium for the month. So that is one of the trades there. You could obviously still go all the way to the 5th of November. It'll be a little bit before earnings, but I think at that point, it's going to be a lot higher in volatility because earnings are coming up. But you could potentially do the $15.50 strike price, which is a little bit over 1%, which is about 34 days from now. So that is one of the trades there I am considering entering. Maybe about 2 or 3 puts that I might buy. We'll see there, because I do have a couple other trades that I want to show you. And the next one here, guys, that I am considering trading is AMD, which is currently trading about $102.45. Right now, if we look at the Bollinger Band and we're look at the maybe 3 months, you'll see that the upper bound for the Bollinger Band is at $109.87. The middle of the Bollinger Band is at $104.95. So typically the price should bounce back to around $104.95. That's kind of like the average. And then the lower bound is at $100.02. So we typically can sell a strike price below the lower bound, and you should be about pretty safe with that strike price. You'll see that the 30-day moving average is at $106.27. And if we scroll in a little bit, you'll see that we're way below that. So we're actually close to the, well, I guess our RSI, if we look at it, is at 45. So we're getting close to the oversold. So we could see this being a potential trade for us that we could take. If we look at the options, let me pull up AMD for us, and we can go to the options here. If we look, so the other thing here is AMD is going to be reporting earnings on the 26th of October. So we would want to maybe potentially do the 15th. Let's see how that one goes. But if we scroll down here, we could potentially do about the 95 strike price, which is right around 82 cents or $82, or we could do the 96. So that would be about 1% for 2 weeks, and it's about the delta is about 18, so you have a 72% chance. So that is, well, I guess not 72, but 82. not able to do math early in the morning, but that is a potential trade you could do. But the third one that I do am considering putting in is charge point. So charge point is at about $19.31. If we look at around the, I guess 1 month, you could look here. You'll see that the upper bound for the Bollinger Band for charge point is at $22.35. The center of the Bollinger Band is at $20.81. And then the lower bound is $19.26. And then the 30-day moving average is at $21.20. So right now the stock price is way below both of the 30-day moving average, as well as the middle of the Bollinger Band of $20.81. So hopefully we could see this being oversold, because if we look at the RSI, it's at 37. So I think this one would be a potential good trade. Anything below 18 as a strike price, I would probably play it a little safer and go with like a 15, 16, depending on what there is, which if I pull it up on Webull, I can show you guys those as well. And we can definitely look at them. So let me pull those up for you. So I have charge point here with the options. And if we look, maybe remember, earnings on charge point is potentially the 15th of November. This one isn't confirmed fully, but we just have to play it for about 27 days, which is October 29th. I think we should be pretty safe on that one. So if we look on the 29th of October, which is 27 days, we could potentially enter the strike price of $15, which is around currently about $19 that you could collect in premium, which is 1% for the month. So this is a pretty safe trade, I think, in my personal opinion. We could do the 16, potentially go up to that and get 2% for the month, but it's entering at a higher risk, right? So right now you could trade at anything below 18 as a strike price. It should be pretty safe, but I like to be more conservative because I am using options buying power. So I'll probably pick the 15, the 16 strike price, depending on what the market does this coming week. But we'll see. But these are the current three trades that I'm potentially considering entering, guys. Let me go ahead and show you guys how much we actually made for the week. And our Webull, well, I guess in our spreadsheet, so that we can go ahead and wrap up this video. So if you guys stuck all the way to the very end, be sure that you're subscribed so that you're notified when I upload new videos. I typically upload these every week. So as we're currently here at the Webull, well, I guess the Google Sheets, and you'll see that if we look at the starting date for us was the 27th, and we look at the end date, which was the 1st of October. So let's find out how much we made. So we made $41.08. This week I didn't really focus on anything. I really just put a covered calls, and I just went on with my day. So they all expired worthless, as you guys saw earlier. And so total we bought in credits, we collected, which was $74, and then we actually bought back $32, and this was from the charge point that we collected at a 50% profit, which is a pretty good trade in my opinion. If we look at the weekly performance, you'll see week 69, we collected $41.08, which brings our total to $59,219.68. This is assuming our initial investment plus all the premium we've collected so far, assuming we don't sell any of our shares at a loss. So at least we sell them at our cost basis. So if we look over here, total we've collected is $12,800 in premium. If we look for this at the current return of investment, is about 27.58%. If we were to account for taxes, which this is a taxable account, it would be at $19.30, 19.30%. Sorry guys, it's morning, Saturday morning, really early, and this is what happens in the morning. So typically I'm half asleep still. So over here, if you look at the credits, you'll see we still have the NEO cash secured puts, which we actually placed on the 7th of September, and we are going to hopefully close them out this coming week. So it's pretty exciting. This how much we collected in NEO, and this was typically like a 30-day trade. And again, I'm really liking the 30-day trades. I think they give us plenty of time to see what the market will do. And so the other one here, you'll see that we did close the charge point one, which I showed you guys earlier. We do have the rolled ones from SoFi. So here's the ones that I did. So I did place a trade for Mara. It's on the 27th. And then I closed them out 3 days later. So this was because I collected, I believe, 70% of the premium, and I still had plenty of time. So that's what I did, because then I placed another covered calls for that week, and we collected about $7, but I squeezed out a little bit more premium on the Mara. So that was a pretty good trade. And then as you'll see, here's the Tattoo Chef covered calls, which expired worthless. These also expired worthless, and then Beyond Meat's covered calls expired worthless, and then Neil's expired worthless. So that was a pretty good week. And if we look at the debits, this is what we bought back the Mara ones, which we collected quite a bit of money for those, especially for the fact that we are quite a bit down for those. If we look at the gains, there was actually nothing in gains this week, and current buys, nothing in current buys at the moment. But this is all I have for you guys in this update. Again, if you haven't subscribed, be sure that you're subscribed with that bell notification so you're notified when I upload new videos. I typically do these weekly, and we will try to get to the goal of making $1,000 a week from selling options eventually. That is our journey towards that, so let's see how long that takes us. We're definitely learning and on our way there, so I'm really excited to see how long it takes us. But anyways guys, thanks so much for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Take care, stay safe out there. Bye guys.